It is a happy day because it is Christmas. But in a few hours, it will not be Christmas anymore. And then, after 1 week, celebrating New Year, we will bring down our Christmas decorations. We will bring down the Christmas tree and then stock our Christmas gifts. It is ordinary month again. And the question needs to be asked, is Christmas only one day in the whole year? According to our Filipino Christmas song, sana araw-araw Paskong lagi. So where do we go from here after celebrating Christmas? According to Jose Marichan, Christmas is in our hearts. But is that enough? Christmas in the heart is nice and warm and romantic. But if Christmas will remain only in our hearts, then it will soon die out of dryness. Because the gospel that was read to us today did not say the word became heart. The gospel did not say the word became feelings. The gospel did not say the word became a sentimental feeling. The gospel said the word was made flesh. In other words, Christmas needs a translation, and the translation of Christmas is into our lives. Christmas in our hearts is romantic and nice. It is even poetic. It is nice to hear. But Christmas lived in our lives can sanctify us. Christmas lived in our hearts would be making us romantic poets. But Christmas translated into our everyday lives is the one that will sanctify, is the one that will inspire, is the one that will edify others. Do we end from there? No. After Christmas is translated into our lives, the gospel says to us, and He lived among us. In other words, the Christmas spirit is not just for individual persons to live. The Christmas spirit must make us brothers and sisters. The Christmas spirit must be translated not only personally by persons, but communally as a community. Ang ibig pong sabihin ito, hindi lang Pasko sa puso o hindi lang Pasko sa pagkataon natin, kundi Pasko sa pamayanan. What the Christmas challenge poses to us is this: He lived among us. Christmas must be proven in the way we live our family. Christmas must be proven in the way we run government. Christmas must be proven in the way we conduct business. Christmas must be proven in the way we vote, in the way we pay taxes, in the way we relate with other nations. The Christmas spirit must be translated into community, because the Lord in the gospel said, the word was made flesh. Is that it? Not yet. There is still a third, a wider movement. The word was made flesh. It must be translated into life. And the word made flesh translated into personal lives must be translated into community. Is that it? No. Because the gospel also says, there were many who rejected Him. There were many who did not believe. In other words, the Christmas spirit should make us reach out to others. Look for people who hate God. Look for people who are indifferent to God. Look for people who do not care about God. And the Christmas spirit, the Christmas message, must be brought to them. Do not expect God to speak from heaven in order to touch people who are angry at Him, because God needs us. His own did not accept Him. His very own rejected Him. If we are true Christians, we cannot tolerate people rejecting God. We cannot tolerate people refusing to believe in God. We cannot tolerate people who set God aside, who just say, "Yes, I believe in God, but who cares?" My dear brothers and sisters, the gospel says the Word was made flesh. But what has happened? The flesh was made Word, and Word, and Word, and Word. No proof, just words. Words can be very smooth. Words can be very easy to speak. Words can be very easy to utter. But it is by living the gospel, living the Word in our lives. So three movements for after Christmas. Number one, the Word, the Christmas Spirit, must be lived. After living the Christmas Spirit must be lived in the community. And after living the Christmas Spirit in the community, the whole community must reach out to those who hate God, who are cold to God, who do not care about God. And then, in the end, may there be no more people who will hate God. May every people accept Him. Christmas in our hearts is romantic and nice, but Christmas lived every day in our lives will sanctify us and make us saints.